Welcome again to Dupnitsa, Bulgaria, 2023 F5J World Championship. We are now waiting for the first fly-off round of seniors, and all 14 points in the corridor are occupied. Weather is still the same, relatively high winds, constant winds. Barely a cloud in the sky, and even birds are hiding. So flying is extremely difficult, far from being a relaxing, joyful event. This is really, really stressful, hard work. I don't expect any low starts. We've seen 15-minute flight from a junior just short while ago, so I also don't expect any late starts. It is apparently possible to fly for 15 minutes now. So let's see how many of top 14 senior pilots will be able to do it. Two minutes to start. I think that was Antonis, head of Siam, making pictures.
Seconds.
Let's see what happens. Everyone's going to the south. Everyone started immediately, as far as I can tell. Okay, there was 1 10-second delay. He's also going to the south. And I think one guy is still waiting. Yep, one more guy is still waiting. But everyone is now up towards the mountain. Probably because the junior in the previous flight did 15 minutes hanging over the... Oh, that was a bad start. Sounded like a prop cavitated. Pity. too much power. See what we can see. Not much, I guess. Sorry for that. But everyone's pretty high and mostly keeping upwind. No one yet went downwind, which is a sensible strategy if you ask me. Let's see if I can get the lowest guy here. He is. There are a few actually. So this guy is the closest and the lowest right now. Everyone else that I can see is further away and also much higher. I probably lost him now. No, still here. Cloud for reference so that you can see what he's actually doing, and the ridge looks like he's losing height pretty fast. Okay, actually whole group now moved over here and lost lots of height. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 planes at least are really low, but I see that there are at least 2 that are still really far away and really high. Okay. So this becomes a competition in eyesight as well. And who's more of a daredevil to fly really far away. These are the 2 guys that are still high. But even they lost quite some height now in the last minute. Landing already. Two planes really far up there, at the edge of the cloud. I'm pretty sure these two guys must be the winners. If they can do one more flight like that. Some pilots are now moving slightly downwind. Not sure how that helps. And there's one guy still up there. Just hanging there, doing nothing. I mean, as long as that works for him, I would do the same. Don't dissipate energy, just try to do as little movement as possible. But even now he decided to do a circle. And he's also slowly coming back to us. What's the time? About 9 minutes of flying done. He still has to find something. Now the rest of the group is all mostly here, hanging around here. Ow! That was unnecessary. So that's flying without a wingtip. Planes fly surprisingly well. This will be a refly. Okay, 15 more minutes or 20 more minutes of standing in the sun. To go. So this tree is, I don't know, about 150 meters downwind. Give you an idea how far the planes are. I mean, it's from this height it's already difficult to come back. Let's see if they can make it. Yep, he made it. Very nice. Next one. Another crash, looks like a radio issue. Plane went into a tight spin and crashed. I think that was Marco Gala on spot number 14. Drama all the way. I think this is the last plane in the air. Minutes, he's still trying to fight for those minutes. That's competition for you guys. Now one more turn and I'm not sure he can make it back. Actually there are two planes in there. So he has a reason to continue, okay? Go. Let's see if I can get both landings. Oh, there's now a third plane coming from somewhere. Three pilots did full 15 minutes. And I guess without the crash and without the mid-air collision, that would be 5 or 6. Very good. Okay. Now, ready fly. Waiting now for the refly start. Expectations. So those three pilots that had a full flight can now try for a really low start. Others, I expect, will try to improve their score. Especially those without the score. So the one that had a mid-air and a crash. Seconds to go. I expect the strategy to be much the same. Far towards the south, towards the mountain. And hope for the best. So I was thinking, if there is some 10 meters per second wind speed,
10 seconds, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3,
you need to fly at 20 meters per second into the wind to reach like 600 meters upwind. So there's some crazy flying already. So you need a motor that can push you at 30 meters per second horizontally. One leg start. That's actually one guy to the north side of the valley. And this one starting late flew towards him. But let's focus on this side as we're closer. For now, guys are just hanging there, waiting for some good air to come by. Not much luck now, and guys already pretty close to landing. I hope no one hits me. Really whistling now. Got a nice landing, but that will be his score now. Oops. My headgear still wants to fly away. In the air. So three more are getting ready to land.
Minutes remaining.
So this was like a normal 5-minute flight for this week. Too far. Who's still flying? Some people still looking in the air. Let's see if I can find two more planes. Slightly downwind here. Hanging around, doing nothing. They will have to go for landing now. They're just over me at pretty low height. I can really lie all the way like this. Very nice. Very nice. There's one more plane. I think one on the Croatian team. Recognizable by their elevators. Ay. Unnecessary drama on landing, but that's what happens if you go landing from the wrong direction.
A little bit best of show and the world champion goes down.
He tried to kill the previous world champion to make sure he would be taken.
Comments are here are best of show. Okay, no crashes this time, let's wait for second flyoff. Second flight for the the senior flyoffs. Weather condition much the same. Still windy. Nothing there that would tell you whether to go left, straight ahead or right.
Seconds to start.
Majority going to the south again. Just one going to the north. I heard another late start with some prop cavitation. And let's see what we can see now after 30 seconds. Group of planes just here, very far forward. And then there's one guy just on this little puff of cloud, hanging there. Largest crowd is moving downwind slowly. And they look pretty close together. Let's hope there are no more crashes. Not sure why would you want to keep this close in this kind of weather. Looks like the south side is losing height again pretty fast. Especially the ones that were forward are now almost getting ready to land. But the ones that went downwind are still kind of high. So definitely in a better position than the guy I showed you before. But also going down now. this guy seems to have found a bit of a good air. Let's see if the other one joining him from below thinks the same. Don't crash again, guys. That was a smart move, but maybe. Okay. Who's still flying? Still, four planes still in the air. To go. my maximum zoom and he's pretty far out for, what is it, 4.5 minutes? No, less than 4 minutes. This is going to be a challenge. Flying into the sun, but I guess it's directly behind that tree there, which kind of makes sense. He has to come back. Can I even find him? Just a little bit of shining there. Directly overhead, flying into the sun, so can't really do much about that. Let's focus on the pilots for a change. Like a couple of guys made it. And it almost makes sense to try to get in line with them. Maybe about here.
Remaining.
I just don't see anyone. There's one above me. Maybe I can follow that one.
Twenty seconds.
Where are the others? Coming into the frame.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Yeah! 4, 3, 2.
Amazing. Congratulations, guys. That was a sight to see.
Thank you very much.
Yes. Next flight tomorrow morning. Hoping for a calmer wind.
Boss again, thank you very much.
And some low level action.
Last flight of today.